played this guitar up until the recording of One Man Dog. And John McLaughlin had written a song called Someone, which we recorded, and he played beautiful guitar on. And the guitar he was playing was one of these. It was a Whitebook, made by Mark Whitebook in Southern California. He was a great guitar maker, and he made a couple of these guitars for me. He put my tattoo, I've got a tattoo on my shoulder. My sister Kate, when I was living in London recording there, my sister Kate came over, and she was fixated on getting a tattoo. She had made this little design, which was the sun, the moon and the ocean, which is a reproduction of this tattoo on my shoulder right here, see? Yeah, like that. And she insisted on getting this tattoo. But when we found a tattoo artist, the only way he would give my sister this tattoo is if I agreed to get it too. She had sold him on the idea of tattooing a woman by the fact that it was a family, sort of a family thing. And he said, okay, if it's a family thing, he gets it too. So I got this tattoo, and Mark Whitebook put it on this headstock of this guitar. I'm going to walk out of frame for a second. Hang on. Here's another guitar with that same that my son Ben had made for me. It's made by Kenji Okamura in London. A beautiful little guitar that Ben gave me as a present. This guitar I played I think the first album I recorded with it was Walking Man, so it was probably it was written on it. Continued playing this guitar until it became community property for a while, and I lost it in the early 80s. And I needed a guitar that could be amplified on stage. This one didn't have a pickup in it yet, and so I bought a Takamine, which was sort of just a brand guitar, a mass-produced guitar, but a good one, Japanese guitar with a pickup already built into it, and this was sort of a step. It served us really well for a while. Served me well. I don't think I ever recorded with it, but I definitely played it live for a couple of years. It has a simple volume and tone control on it. And but eventually I got a hold of this Yamaha guitar, and in the mid 80s, and Yamaha also made me a custom guitar and put my name on the back. But this was the guitar that the first Yamaha that I played, and they stood in. They did really well for me. They were a good guitar. Very bright sounding guitar, and again it had a pickup built into it, amplified really well. We would cover the hole to this to keep the feedback down. But nice sort of everyman's guitar. Did the job.